Hey guys, it's Justin. In today's video, we're going to go through a step-by-step tutorial on setting up TE Smart's new A2U KVM. We're going to show you guys how we set up the desktop, a laptop, as well as the Xbox and an Apple TV, and teleconferencing like you can see here. So stay tuned. We're going to start with an unboxing, and then we're going to do the tutorial, and then we're going to show you how to do a headset with the Xbox at the end. The video after this is going to be the troubleshooting techniques. All right, let's jump into it. All right, we're back for the unboxing. Let's go ahead and open this up. And the top here, we've got a couple cards as well as the manual. The card is going to help you find the setup information. Another card here will have the frequently asked questions as well as some troubleshooting techniques. And then, of course, we have the manual. Let's go ahead and get everything out of the box. Underneath the KVM, you're going to find the rest of the components here. Pull these out of here. Now here we have a basic 5-volt adapter. There's really nothing special here. Then we've got our remote control. Now what's interesting about the remote control is that it does not ship with a CR2025 battery due to shipping limitations. So if you want to use a remote, you will need to pick one of those up. It's basic little 4-button remote. Then we have our 2 cables that come with a 4-port. Now these are just HDMI and USB cables that are connected together by the jacket. You can see they're just fused together here. It does only come with 2 cables for the 4-port, so if you want to connect more devices, you can just use your regular HDMI and USB cables that you have at home. There's nothing proprietary about them. In fact, that's why it only ships with 2, is because everybody has HDMI and USB cables already. Let me open up our KVM here. Now the KVM is a A2U 4-port unit. You can tell it's an A2U because it has the mode light here. And then on the back, we've got our output as well as our 4 inputs. So we're gonna go ahead and set some things up, and then we're gonna come back and do the step-by-step guide. All right, so we set up all of our components, and now we're gonna start by setting up our computers, and then we're gonna do the Xbox, and then we're gonna do the Apple TV. So let's go ahead and go to the back of the desk, and let's start making those connections. Now, one of the things that's really important that you want to take into consideration when you're thinking about how to set up the KVM is that if you have a desktop computer that has graphics cards like we do here, the graphics card is gonna override the video output of the motherboard. So let's go ahead and connect the video connection here to the graphics card, and then we'll connect the USB to the motherboard. Then we'll run that cable over to USB 1 and input 1. For the MacBook Pro, we're using the Apple multiport adapter, which has a power, HDMI, and USB. We're not going to worry about the power because we have that connected directly to the MacBook Pro. So let's just go ahead and connect the HDMI and the USB here. This is a Type-C adapter, so we've connected to the Type-C port. And then we'll run the other side of the cable over to the KVM. Go into USB 2 and input 2. For the Apple TV, it does not have a USB port, so we're just going to use a regular HDMI cable. And plug that into input 3. The Xbox, on the other hand, we do want to connect the USB because we want to be able to use the mouse and keyboard for gaming. So we go to USB 4, input 4, connect the HDMI, and the USB. Now, for the mouse and keyboard, we're using Logitech wireless devices. We're going to plug that into the dedicated mouse and keyboard port. It doesn't matter which goes in which port, and also if you have a unified device where one dongle for mouse and keyboard, just plug it in one of the two of those, it'll be fine. We've got our video output, and then just to save time, we've already run power here. So let's go to the front of the desk, and let's turn this on. Okay, so our first step here is to turn the KVM on. And you'll notice LED 1, 2, and 4 are activated. 3 is not because we did not make a USB connection to the Apple TV. So our Windows computer came right up. We got mouse and we've got keyboard. Let's switch over to 2, which is a MacBook Pro. I think we need to turn this on. Okay, there we go. So you can use the MacBook Pro or any laptop device, open or close. It's your choice. A lot of people like to use them open. That way they get 2 screens. So let's log in. We're good here. We actually got the mouse on both screens. Let's go over to our Apple TV. This is working okay. And finally, let's go over to our Xbox. Let's grab this. Wake up the controller here. So that's working. And the keyboard is also controlling the Xbox as well. Okay, so that's it for the setup on this. We're going to come back in a second and we're going to connect the webcam as well as the headsets and the USB hub. Stay tuned. All right, so we're back here to set up our teleconferencing and we have our powered USB hub here. Now, it's very important to use a powered USB hub if you're going to connect more than one device to the USB 2.0 port. If you don't, you can draw too much power through that port and the KVM will start to act erratic. So the first thing you want to do is always connect power to the hub first. And then we're going to connect the webcam, which is already above our monitor here. And then after that, we're going to connect the receiver for our headset. Now, this receiver is a little bit different because it uses RF, radio frequency, instead of Bluetooth. Works better with a KVM. And it can also do Xbox as well as PC. And we'll go over that in a second as well. So let's go ahead and connect the hub to the back of the KVM. And let's run the receiver here to the front because we're going to use that in a second. Lastly, we're going to connect the speakers to the audio output of the KVM. Now we're going to go to the front of the device and see how everything is working. So the first step that we're going to want to do is turn the speakers on. And I find that Zoom is one of the easiest ways to test everything. So let's go ahead and load Zoom and come over to our settings. Go to our video, and here we are on our video. Let's go to audio. Now, for the speakers, you're going to want to choose the output that is the name of your monitor. So here we're using LG Ultra Gear. Let's select that and test the speakers so we can hear the speakers. So they're working good. And now let's go ahead and turn our headset on. All right, now that that's on, we can find our... Oh, we actually have these set for Xbox mode, so let's switch over here back to PC mode. And then now here we can find our headphones. We can test them, we can hear those defined. And now we can also see that we've got our microphone working here as well. Now, if we want to use the same headset with the Xbox, it's really important you need to switch this over to Xbox mode first before switching to the Xbox. Switch that over. And then let's go ahead and switch over to our Xbox with the KVM. And now that we're here, we need to give it about 10 seconds or so, and the receiver will pair with the headphones, which will match into the Xbox. Yep, there we go, headsets assigned. All right, that's it for today's video. We're actually gonna do the troubleshooting segment in another video coming up right after this, so stay tuned for that. Thanks and have a good day.